helping me call this one is Kirk Herbstreit, and Aaron Andrews also joined us on the sidelines. Tonight's college football action is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste and zero calories. We've got the Michigan Wolverines and the Nittany Lions of Penn State. Game that's played here in the Big Ten, they seem to get more and more significant. This should be a great one. For Penn State, one of the real highlights of their defense is a shutdown cornerback.
I cannot wait to watch him staying with a wide receiver who's really top caliber. The two of them ought to have a good bout today.
And it's almost time for kickoff, but first, let's send you down to midfield for the coin toss, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste and zero calories. Teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. He'll return it from the three. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. For Michigan, give us a sense of how their offense works.
You want to watch how quickly a lot of their plays develop. It's all about ball control with this offense. And they use a lot of quick passing routes and a lot of three-step drops. It doesn't give the defenders a whole lot of time to react.
He's got it out to his tight end. There's some daylight. Across midfield. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. Touchdown! What a catch and a big touchdown from the tight end.
I'll tell you, this tight end is a big-time football player. He might like to talk a little bit out there on the field, but he has the type of game to back it up.
And he tacks on the extra point. A quick two-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
The score now, 7-0. From their own 20-yard line, it's first down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. A gain of about 4 yards on the draw. The handoff. Watch out. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 36. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 42. It's complete. He's taken down at the 34. A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back, and the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
Tosses left. He gets to about the 24-yard line. So with that run, they pick up another first.
It's a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
He'll get it again. He makes his way out to about the 12. So his fifth run of the drive goes for another first down.
This offense is running the ball very effectively on this drive.
Looks to the receiver, touchdown! That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, the
they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can think the play calling there. Very impressive.
They got great concentration from everyone to connect on that flag pattern. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. A nice 7-play, 80-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. Penn State lines up for the kickoff. Taken at the 5. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. They'll set up shot at the 23. First down, 10 yards to go. To the 30. He's tackled at the 41-yard line. That was a great call.
Yeah, here you see the draw play at its best. The tailback got good blocking up front and was able to pick up a bunch of yards.
He makes his way to about the 45. From the 45-yard line, first down. Takes it right and brought down right away. 3-yard gain by the running back. Pass to the tight end, but he bottles it all away.
I know this quarterback trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
Throws a laser across the middle.
Wow, that looks like a generous spot to me. I thought he was a little bit short.
Give to the tailback, and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Nice play here by the senior to make the sure tackle. It's not very often that someone's able to shake this guy.
For a loss.
I tell you what, for defensive back, this kid is a sure tackler, and he showed it right there.
Looks to pass. It's picked up by the defense. And that's a very heads-up play by the defensive end to jump on that fumble.
Here's a great job of the defense there to take advantage of the mistake and cause that turnover.
Drops back on first down. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
I like how the blitz was identified and then picked up. That's a good test for a quarterback. How does he react in the face of pressure?
They'll go ground. Runs outside for a nice gain. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. They take to the ground, and he's got the first. Gains his way to the 7-yard line. It's first down. 6 yards stand between them and 6 points. And so we've reached the end of quarter number one, and we're all tied up. It's first down. They'll be looking for 6 points here. And he makes it out to about the 5-yard line. The running back gets 2 on the carry.
I'm telling you, every yard you gain is earned, and those were about as tough as they come.
They go with a run. Touchdown!
He's got nose for the end zone. What more can you say? He wasn't giving up on that run until he was in for the score.
He makes the PAT. So a 5-play, 50-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So the score now, 14-7. And he got all of this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The offense will take over at the 20. Someone wanted a little head start there.
Looks like they got a little too anxious trying to jump the snap count.
First and five. Ball on the 25. They go with the back, and he's got room. He makes his way to about the 42. From their own 42-yard line. First down. Straight run here. He's got nowhere to go.
That was just a case of one lineman dominating another and making the play.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Left, not behind the line.
You can't teach instinct. The ability to know where a play is going is something this safety has. That was a terrific effort.
Bat it away. And that makes it fourth down.
Boy, great defense on that play. They were expecting the pass, and they defended it very well by getting a hand in there to break up the play.
Taken down at the 28. So we got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. First down, look at the throw. He goes down at the 18.
Believe it or not, there are a lot of quarterbacks who welcome pressure. They want the defense to come after them because it leaves some gaps in the coverage. As long as they can make that quick read, it can go for a lot of yards.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
I'm sure the coaches are going to tell them to calm down and be more careful, because I guarantee you, nobody keeps throwing those passes into the defense like that without making a mistake.
Down at the one, and the halfback's got nowhere to go. From the 1 yard line, second down. Option right side.
I think the option down by the goal line is a great call. It puts so much pressure on the defense and allows the quarterback to have the decision to run it or pitch it. This time it worked to perfection.
Converts the extra point. A four-play, 71-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot. They also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
The score now, 21-7. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They'll take over the 20-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Give up the middle, tackle right away. Picked up a yard, if anything, on that run. The hit knocks it loose, incomplete.
That was what I call a power play in pass defense. He made solid contact and forced the incompletion.
Look at the throw. That's a great tackle at the 10.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. Made at the 49-yard line. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. From the 44-yard line, second down. Nice run, and he's brought down. So we got a few yards on that carry.
If you can continue to pick up small chunks of yards like that, you can really start to wear a defense down.
Deep pass to the end zone. Incomplete. It's knocked down by the defense.
He's got to be more careful with these rainbow passes. You don't want to give the defenders enough time to catch up with the ball and make the pick. Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home. Blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
He's going to try and scramble. Knocked out of bounds at the 26-yard line. And he manages to get out of bounds after that run.
Good running here. He manages to get to the outside and gets a nice pickup.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line.
Just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 6-play, 48-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. So our score, 28-7. He just drills this one. It out to maybe the 19-yard line. The offense will take over at the 19. First and 10. Counter play. Take it down to the backfield. And that'll do it for the first half. Still plenty of football to be played. The score here at Beaver Stadium is the Nittany Lions 28, the Wolverines 7. Michigan will be kicking off to start the second half. Sends it sailing downfield. Looking for the corner. He's tackled at the 23-yard line. The offense will take over at the 23. It's first and 10. For Penn State, they had success in the first half and can really pull away if they can score here. Aaron Andrews will give us more detail. EA?
Two very different emotions being showed on each sideline, Brad, as the first half ended. Happy and energetic on one, but the other somber and a bit confused. And for Michigan, they allowed a couple of huge plays and would like to see that corrected in the second half. Brad, back up to you.
And a huge run by the tailback.
This guy's always had outstanding vision, but it seems he's got some incredible quickness as well once he gets into the open field.
They'll take it inside, but the defense is ready. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on their own 49. Takes the handoff inside and stopped immediately. Nowhere to go on the delay. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle made at the 49.
They might have been able to catch the defense off guard with a play-action pass there, but by going to the ground, they didn't have much of an opening.
It's fourth down. And they're ready to punt this one away. The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The offense will start at the 20-yard line. Drops back on first down. The 50. He goes down at the 46. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage, and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry. Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again. There's a very impressive open field tackle. 7-yard play.
Hey, they picked up a nice gain of 7 yards on that play. Great pass.
Passes to the right. It's picked off. He's at the 30. With a 10. And he scores. Touchdown.
Great job here by the defender breaking on the ball and taking it to the house. Man, those pick sixes can really hurt an offense and have a lasting impact.
And he adds the extra point. Penn State is lining up to kick this one off.
Trying to squeeze that ball into a tight spot.
Yeah, I know it was incomplete, but he didn't have too many other options.
Quick out to his receiver. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line.
The quarterback dumped it off, and everyone did a good job of blocking up front. Doesn't get much better than that.
Now let's hear from Aaron Andrews on some injury news. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Thank you, Brad. When it first happened, the concern on the sideline was that he had suffered broken ribs. But after taking a better look, the trainers feel confident he suffered a bruised sternum. They're hoping it isn't serious and are holding him out for the rest of the game as a precaution. Proud of you guys in the booth.
Well, these guys are going to have to find somebody else to step up now. Thanks, Aaron. And a nice run by the tailback.
Not a lot of razzle-dazzle here, but it gets the job done and picks up the first down.
They'll go with the option. He might have a chance. The 10. And a huge touchdown play.
Great play here by the defender. You know, it's trickier than it looks to scoop up a loose ball and then get your motor started. He was able to do it and made that play look smooth for the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. Penn State is ready to kick it away. He'll return it from the 3. Oh, he got nailed on that one. They'll start this drive at the 25. First and 10. He's met immediately. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the senior corner who came in from the outside and made a nice play.
Drops back and brought down immediately. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and to cause him some problems.
Going to be sacked. And that'll be his fifth sack of the season.
I'll tell you what, this guy seems to give maximum effort on every play. He is so hard. hard to keep off the quarterback.
And it looks like they're going to run away with this one as we head into the fourth quarter. The score here at Beaver Stadium is Penn State 42, Michigan 7. Sack makes this a fourth and very long. And that was excellent punt coverage.
I agree, Brad. That was very well defended.
From the 50, first down. Give to the tailback. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. And the tailback broke that one for a very nice game.
Give the offensive line some kudos there. They blocked very well up front to create the holes for this back.
They'll make the sack. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
Again with a carry. He makes his way out to about the 35. They show pass and then hand it to the back for a pickup of 8 yards. Third down, and they need to get it to the 23. He launches one for the end zone. And he makes a spectacular play in the end zone.
Keep an eye out for this cornerback. It's going to be interesting to see if they continue to throw the ball in his direction.
So they're going to go for it here. Drops back to pass. And he's hit immediately.
Unbelievable pass. They don't care what down it is.
First down on the 12, and they can smell the goal line. He fights forward to about the 10. 3 yard gain by the running back. On the ground with the tailback. He fights forward to about the 7. The back gets 3 on the carry.
Just a great job here by the defender of timing the hit and getting him down.
He'll get the call again. And once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
When Heisman voters are trying to decide who will get their support, they're going to be thinking about performances like this one he's having here today.
And he adds the extra point. A nice 8-play, 50-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. The score now, 29-7. Penn State is ready to kick it away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense will take over at the 20-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. It's been an impressive game by this defensive lineman.
Well, he's a physical force. You know, when he puts those big knee hooks on you, there's only one direction and one speed that you can go, and that is down and quickly. I think it has a lot to do with the way they're pressuring the quarterback. They're just doing a great job as a unit and not allowing this quarterback to get into any rhythm. I'm not even sure the ball carrier saw the corner coming for him. That happened so fast, he never had a chance to make a move.
Look at the throw. This one's intercepted. It's the sophomore safety. They'll bring him down to the 33-yard line.
I think that interception pretty much sums up this whole game. The throw was lousy, and the defense simply stepped up and made yet another play.
Taken down in the backfield.
Well, I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he's stopped before he even gets going.
Tackle at the 31. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. coming up on this one. Ball on the 31-yard line. Under pressure. Ball is loose. Fumble. Good hustle there by the D lineman.
It's often an overused term when referring to defensive linemen, but that's what they mean when they talk about a guy has a motor that's running. He never quit, and he played to the whistle.
He's taken down at the 20. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Brought down at the 10-yard line. Second down. They are 10 yards away. Makes the catch and look out. Tight end. This guy can play some football.
You bet he can. He's such an all-around player. He's just as good at blocking as he is at catching the football.
And he hits the PAT. A short three-play, 35-yard drive. And a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
So our score, 49-14. He's taken down at the 45-yard line. Boy, dreams they had of a comeback just ended right there.
Yeah, Brad, even if they were able to recover that onside kick, they still probably would not have had enough time.
Fires deep down the right side. Pick by the safety.
Safety that time just sitting back there looking at the quarterback, and once it was thrown, he knew exactly where it was going and he made the pick.
Receivers got it on the screen and they make the stop at the 8. They line up at the 8. It's second down. As we take a look at the highlights, Kurt, how would you summarize the action of this one?
It takes a really impressive performance to win by this wide a margin against a team that, at least on paper, is so evenly matched. They earned a lot of respect here. Penn State won this game in emphatic and surprising fashion. I was expecting this to come down to the last possession. Maybe even going into overtime. Instead, they just ran away with it.
Great effort today by this young man, leading his team to a win, and in the process, earning Player of the Game honors. For Penn State, they remain undefeated on the year. And for Michigan, the fans are not going to be happy about the second loss of the season. Thanks for joining us in NCAA Football as well. For Kirk Herbstreit and Aaron Andrews, this is Brad Nessler saying so long.